Hi, Eva Nichols here. Here is a little easy and fun watercolor project for you, and it's great for kids as well. So enjoy, and thank you, Camilla.
I just got so inspired to do feathers the other day because I watched a gal both on YouTube, and she's on Skillshare, where I'm also, and she also is on Patreon, which I don't know if you're familiar with that, but that's a site where you can, you know, subscribe and you pay whatever, a little subscription fee, and then you support that artist, you know. And some artists, they have, you know, thousands of supporters and they make a full-time living doing that. But anyway, Camilla just started, Camilla just recently started her Patreon page, and I've been following her for probably a couple of years, and I like her. She's a young watercolorist from Denmark, so you know, I think it's like a little visit with Denmark for me to listen to her, because she has such a cute Danish accent, and she's a very talented painter, and she paints very, very loose, and I can highly recommend it, her. I'll write her up on the board if I haven't already. I think she's on my, so, and you can see her free videos on YouTube. Yeah, she puts some videos up there. Sometimes it's just like really, sped up, but sometimes she'll do a longer one, like half an hour or whatever, and explain what she's doing. Mm-hmm. But she paints very, very loosely, and she does a beautiful job at it. All right, so that's enough about that. And so I'm just gonna, for these feathers, I'm just gonna use whatever I have in my palette. So the first thing is either on these two here, I used a little bit of masking fluid to make that white in the middle. I don't even know what it's called. So you can do that, or you can use, again, a white gel pen if you want to have that white. Or nobody says it has to be white. If you give me some of those other feathers, I'm sure there's some of them they're not.
You mask that?
Yeah, I mask that with masking fluid. And I use my masking pen, but you can also just do it with So here you can see it doesn't have much white in the middle. It doesn't have to be with the white. It can also just be with paint. So I take, a smaller round brush and I just make a line. So now this can be the bottom. And then on the bottom of the feathers, they usually have some little, little things sticking out like this until it gets to be a serious feather. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of one of the things that really says this is a feather. It's not a leaf. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of darker in there. And it's really not hard at all. So a little bit darker in there. And I can put a few more of these little things in. And now I'm gonna take maybe a little bit of a bigger brush. This one's number 8. And my water is a little dirty, but it doesn't matter. And then I just put some water in a feathery shape. And I mean, feathers is such an easy shape. And feathers come, some are fatter, some of my paint here is gonna run a little bit, which is exactly what I want. I don't want it too perfect. Can you see how I put water
on either side?
And there's a little bit of white here. Mm-hmm. And if I happen to have a little bit of white, I kind of like it. And now I'm gonna, just with very, very diluted paint first, I'm just gonna get some paint in while it's still wet. Like that, and I'm gonna change the color a little bit. Very often you'll see feathers, they have stripes almost, or sometimes they'll even have dots. It all depends on what bird they're from, right? And they can be very bright colored, like if you've ever found a feather from like the blue jays, they're very bright and black and blue. And can you see how it's already looking like a feather?
Yeah.
I mean, that's already a feather, right?
Wow.
And then I like sometimes, feathers, sometimes they really have very, very straight edges like that, if they're completely from wings or whatever, where they're not destroyed and they haven't been damaged or anything, they can be very very much like that. And you can also go in and then, you know, sometimes they'll be a little messed up. And you can go in and mess up those lines while it's still wet, mm-hmm. so that they're not so perfect. Mm-hmm. You can also, if you really want imperfection, like that's where what Camilla is a master at. By nature, I can't be as loose as she is. I love the way she paints it, but you know, you got to paint you, right? So I got to paint me and not try to be Camilla. Or any other painter for that matter. But can you see now I sprayed into it a little bit and it gives it just a little bit more dimension. And I can go in with whatever kind of muddy color I can find. And then I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna just darken some places. I'll hold it up so you can see too.
Okay.
And put a little bit more color in. And can you see how they just very quickly, it doesn't have to be perfect by any stretch of the imagination. And then you can go in with your credit card.
Wow.
And if you start going in with your credit card, when it's this wet, can you see? I mean, because it's just sprayed into it and it's very wet, right?
Mm-hmm.
I can go in and do that middle vein a little bit more with this pointy part of my gray card. This one, so super pointy. And because the pigment is so wet, it can run a lot. And so it runs in and I created a groove in my watercolor paper, you know, because it's wet and it's cotton. And then I go in and I, you know, scrape with this one. So there's a little groove and then the pigment runs in and it falls in and it goes bloop. And then it can't come out again. And you can also go in and do a little bit of those, you know, side hairs that they have. I don't know what they're called. Somebody who knows what these things are called, they'll let me know. I don't know what they're called, but you know, they have like almost like little hairs and they have little hooks on them and they hook into each other and that's how the feathers stay together. It's like a very intricate system. I think, I don't know if that's what they were, got the idea for Velcro from, I'm not sure.
It was from a plant.
Was that from
like a
plant? Yeah.
You know, like
okay, yeah. But it has kind of like a little bit of that same. And so you can go in, can you see now I scraped in, and can you see, so you get a little bit. Don't do it the whole way up. It's the same thing like when people are painting trees and they paint a Christmas tree plantation with every tree, you know. Everything is like the same and the same and the same. And you can also go in a little bit from the outside and you can scrape out there or whatever, you know, floats your boat. And as it dries, you can still go in with a little bit maybe of a thicker paint and you can go in and create a little bit more darkness certain places if you want to. It's all up to you. Remember, it's your feather. You can do whatever you like. And I think it's one of those, don't, you know, mess around with it too much, because I think the ones I like the best are usually the ones that where I haven't done like overdone it.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, but there's a feather, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, for sure that's a feather.
Now this one looks like you took the water out further somehow.
Well, that's where I sprayed it more.
Oh,
I
okay.
sprayed it more, so I got more of those uneven edges. And I also made it a rounder one at the top. Some feathers are like this, some are pointy. It all depends on the bird and where on the bird the feather came from.
Yeah. What did you do? Is this ink?
Oh, and then so some of them, you know, I decided to just not put very much detail in them. And then when I let them dry, and then I went in with my fine liner or my, you know, micron pen, a really skinny one. This is 0.5, maybe that's my 0.3. Yeah, 0.3. I mean, you can use whatever. So I used a very skinny one. These micron pens, I love them. They have archival ink and it doesn't bleed out. You can paint over it with watercolor. And so on these here, I went in with my little fine liner and just gave it a little. Don't outline the whole thing and don't do the whole inside and don't do all those. Do a few here and there, I think, is the most attractive.
Yes.
So on something where you left it very, very loose, you can go in and do a little bit of pen work and it I think it looks pretty. Mm-hmm. It's all, you know, you can do all sorts of things. You can also let them bleed out a lot more. You can, I think I have somewhere I splattered.
Is that the toothbrush?
No, so I splattered on this one here. I didn't use a toothbrush. You can use a toothbrush, absolutely. But you can also just take a very floppy brush, like for instance, let's see what I have here. Like, you know, if you, either with one of your liner brushes, like, you know, with the long skinny hairs, for instance, make it very wet. I can do it on this one here, maybe. And make it very wet. And then I'm gonna go in here. And then I'm gonna, so watch out, folks. Hopefully you didn't have your best blouse on or anything. I don't want to splatter anyone. But then I just do like this. And see how I tap on it? But those, they go all over the place, see? I mean, and they went on my picture and stuff. I mean, it's just one of those. And if you have areas you don't want it, then you can hold your hand over it or put a little piece of paper over it or whatever that you can do. So, but you can see that's, I think for this kind of a painting, that's actually a nice background.
So nice.
Just kind of fills it out if it's too much white paper. And just basically use the colors that you already have in there. And if it gets too much, you can also go in, and my feathers are dry, so I don't have to worry about it. I can do my dot bottle a little bit to hit some of those dots. And then that way, and you can take, while it's still wet, if you didn't want any or too much splatter on your feathers, you can just kind of dab them out. They come out really easily. Or if some of them were like a little much, you can just kind of dab them up a little bit. But can you see? And then that way, voila, done.
So nice. Makes a nice bookmark.
Makes a super nice bookmark if you paint them on, like I did here, a whole bunch of them on these scrap pieces of paper. And as I said, you know, laminate them, you know, punch a little hole in. You could also, you know, depending on, you know, how long your paper is and how everything turned out, you could also kind of, you know, cut off the corner so it's a little pointy. Whatever you want to do, you can do. And as I said, you know, you can maybe make a nice little sentiment on the back.
It's so nice. Yeah.
And then that little tassel on.
Looks so professional. Is this a masking pen?
That is a masking pen. Hmm. And it looks like this.
Does it get sticky?
And then there's a masking fluid inside, and so you can, you know.
Because that masking stuff gets kind of dry, doesn't it?
Well, yes, it's supposed to dry on your paper, and you don't want to dry, you don't want to put it on. So if you're using masking fluid, we'll use a little bit next week. I was going to show you how to use masking fluid.
Oh, good.
But masking fluid is one of those things you got to use correctly. You don't ever want to put it on, like I don't want to put it on here where there's water on. It has to be on dry paper. Your paper has to be completely dry when you put it on. Let me see if I can find another little piece.
Do you fill that?
Can
you
refill it? Yes, you can refill it. I never tried to do it, but apparently you can refill it. So if I wanted to do a feather here and I wanted to mask out, I would just, and when I mask these feathers, I usually like to skip a little bit so it's not too solid. And then it has to be dry. It has, you have to wait until it's dry, and you know it's not dry quite yet. But and then you can feel, and it doesn't come off. And then you can paint over it. And then
erase it.
No, not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet. Yeah, because the whole idea is why you put masking fluid on is that you want to save the white on the of the paper. So like here, I put masking fluid in the centers here, right? So and then I could paint over it. And then when everything was dry, I rubbed it off. Okay. And then I'm left with these white spots. And then I can go in and, you know, paint over them or tint them a little bit if the white looks too bright or something like that.
Like batik.
Yeah, I guess. A little bit like batik. So there you have it.
Eva, on these right here, did you use your card in paint to pull out?
No. Okay. I just used... because, I mean, I just had more pigment on here. And then afterwards, I went in with a skinny brush and I put a little bit more pigment on where I, you know, where I wanted to darken it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Looks easy enough.
It's easy enough. Nothing to it.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little exercise and try it out yourself. It's super fun and easy. And thanks again to Camilla Damsbo Brix for the inspiration. And please, if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. Thank you. Happy painting.